cases aren't violent, dangerous prisoners. 85% or better of the people in prison today have some form of substance abuse issues that are involved in their crimes and stuff. And are looking for rehabilitation. They're not providing it. Drug addicts are not receiving treatment in prison.
I know.
Which is, you know, it's just totally ludicrous. Here you have a person in a position where you could treat him. But that's the problem. And I've said this before, and I'll say it again and again. If there was a magic button that if you pressed it, you would instantly rehabilitate all prisoners, reduce recidivism to zero, would the Department of Correction press that button? No, they wouldn't. They do not have a vested interest in putting themselves out of work.
Put them out of work.
The way the concept of, and it's so corrupt, the correctional system is designed to get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And it shouldn't be designed that way. It should be designed to make itself smaller and smaller and smaller and disappear.
Right.
And how does that happen? You rehabilitate the individuals that come into the system. You don't make them worse than they came in. But that's what's happening today. And that's what what's so encouraging about what NOCAD is doing, is because now the torture that goes on in the prison system is absolutely mind-boggling. And like in Massachusetts, the head of the Guards Union refers to rehabilitation programs as coddling prisoners. He does not have a vested interest in allowing prisoners to be rehabilitated.
Well, he doesn't
understand.
Because
if they get rehabilitated, then you have less and less prisoners, which means you need less and less guards.
Exactly right.
And you eventually need less and less institutions, and that brings more and more money to go back to the public general funds.
Right. It does, yeah.
Excuse me, what's wrong with that?
Yeah, well, they don't need... He doesn't even understand his title as correctional officer.
Oh, no, he understands it. He has no vested interest in putting himself out of work.
No, of course not.
And that's what the problem is. And it's going to take the general public to say, hey, listen, you know, everybody needs jobs, blah, 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 but you don't make money off of the rest of us.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, you don't take an individual and turn brats into killers and drop them back into our community. And that's what's going on.
That's exactly what's
That's what the prison system's basically doing. They're taking brats and turning them into killers, and they're dropping them back into the community. And this is the beauty of NOCAD, is NOCAD is now touching a very sensitive area, and they're getting an insight into the fact, hey, we're torturing people in there, and we're putting them back into our communities. This is insane. This has got to stop.
Well, they're dealing at a level of when they're dealing at the higher level of what happens to individuals. Okay, we're talking 10% of the population at any given time is isolated and put in that situation.
Or more.
Okay, so NOCAP is really bitten off a good thing in the fact that they're going in there to see what, hopefully they're trying to deal with.
Well, here's the thing, you know, they've stepped up to the plate.
Right.
And the proof is in the pudding. Up in Maine, legislation is being proposed to limit the amount of time a person can do in isolation and to prohibit putting mentally ill people in segregation.
Right, exactly.
And Richard Kilmer was there when I went up and spoke to the legislature. He was there. NOCAD was there. They're not just giving lip service.
No.
I mean, they're right up front doing it.
Well,
and that's really encouraging to see the religious community stepping up to the plate and seeing enough is enough.
Well, this year they're doing a serious educational campaign. They're trying to get into all the churches and stuff like that. Okay, we'll talk a little bit about later. They're asking that the Red Cross be allowed into our prisons so that because you need some type of ombudsman, let me say, a monitor. You can say we end torture and continue to do it. Just because you say it and you can write it down and you can put it in everything, somebody has to go in and see that it's stopped to check on these situations. And that's one of the things we'll talk about later.
One of the interesting things is the vices of torture. People don't realize the vices that they're using inside the prison. they have a chair. And they can get from us on the website, we can give you the site where you can see, in particularly Maine State Prison, but it's across the country that they're using this thing called a chair, where they strap a guy down into it. But you really have to see the video of the main, where they cut a guy's jumper off, and they put him into the chair, and they're strapping him down, and one guard actually grabs him by the penis, putting him into the chair. Another guy you hear say, give him the gas, and they pull his head back, and they spray mace into this guy's face,
into his mouth,
his nose, and they don't wash this off.
No.
And this guy is strapped down, and he's in an empty cell. Why didn't you just put him in the empty cell? Why did you have to get, this guy sitting in the chair with gas in his nose, his throat, and his eyes, burning his skin, strapped down, he's urinating, defecating on himself, and you don't call that torture? You could have took the same individual and just stuck him in an empty cell. Then what could he do in the empty cell? And now you're going to take this individual, after you do that kind of treatment to him, and put him in the street and think he's going to be a loving, compassionate human being.
Well, our audience needs to see these.
And we got it on the site.
We have it on the site. Oh, on my site, you can go right into nlhome.org. That's nlhome.org. I have to look to my man to make sure that you get to the right site. You go on my site, my website, and you can see that video. Now, obviously, I don't think it's for children to see, but you need to see what actually happens to individuals, and I think...
Well, the BBC report is on the site,
too. And the BBC report is on there, right, exactly.
You watch the BBC site, and it focuses on Texas and Florida.
Right.
And you will see, in Texas, human beings crawling on the floor, being hit with cattle prods, being kicked, and called all kinds of names and stuff. And one individual has a broken ankle, and he can't crawl, so they grab him by the wrist and drag him across the floor. You cannot treat human beings in that manner and expect them to come out being loving, compassionate human beings. They're coming out with great hate and anger that's going to be bestowed upon the community. And that has to stop.
Now, part of the report is, if maybe you can read the devices and tortures, you know, according to Reverend Sala and Nolan Gonzalez, the Minister of Criminal Justice and Human Rights for the United Church of Christ, if you read some of the stuff that's in here, it'd be, you know.
Oh, yeah, you go on their website,
yeah,
and pull this stuff up. I mean, they're using stun guns, they're using mace, and they're using stuff. They have mace that takes the skin off. When you watch, you have to watch the BBC video.
It's unreal.
And it will show you pictures of individuals that were hit with mace. Now, the first time you used it and that happened, okay, you didn't know. But once you know that chemical is capable of doing that, and you continue to use it on human beings, that's torture, and that must stop. And people must be held responsible and accountable for behaving that way and doing that stuff. And you always see, only the worst of the worst are in the supermaxes. It's not true. When they close the mental institutions, the individuals that couldn't survive in the street, there was no mental institutions to put them. They put them in prisons. And when they get into prisons, they can't function in the prison, so they put them in the segregation isolation units. It's not the worst of the worst that are in there. That's a scam. And NOCAT now understands that, and they're going after it. But you really have to take responsibility. Go to NL Home and look at these videos to really understand what's going on. And it shows you they are murdering prisoners, beating them to death, and they're getting away with it. It's outrageous. This has to stop. You have to support NOCAT. You have to talk your